Variable fonts. In addition to being visually interesting, people always ask, yes, but what practical value do they have? It's a good point, and sometimes aesthetics do add a lot of value. But instead of loading tons of weights separately, you upload only one font. And variable fonts often have smaller font sizes because of it. There's broad browser support, and they let me do something like this. In this lesson, we'll cover how to add them, how to control all kinds of axes, like slant and weight and optical size, how to add animated transitions, and how to control them with interactions to make someone's brain melt into pure liquid joy. Adding. At any time, I can go in, add fonts, and upload a custom font. I want to select a font file to upload, and I just upload. And that's it. Back in the designer, I can choose the font I just loaded from the dropdown thing. Second part, axes. If I go in, under more type options, I can see font variations. And when I add them, the first variation loads up. Now I can go into the dropdown and select another axis, but I can just click and drag and adjust along that axis. If I want to add another axis, another property to control, I can combine them however I want and do whatever. Third part, animated transitions. Since I set my axis controls here, I can go to, let's say, hover and make other changes here. I'm just changing the style so it's different on hover. If I escape out, hover over, hover out, hover over, let's animate it. With the element selected, in none, I'll go down and add a transition. And just like I can transition basically any CSS property, let's transition font variations. I can control the whatever, you know the deal. And now, hover over, hover out, hover over. That's right, I have a transparent mouse. Fourth part, interactions. Here's a heading on a page. I added a variable font, but I haven't done anything else to my styling. In interactions, I can add any type of interaction here. In this example, I'll add one to mouse move on the page. So when the mouse is moving over the page, anywhere in the viewport, it'll play this animation. What kind of animation? The one we're making in this very video. And since X is left and right and Y is up and down, with my heading selected, I can just add a point. Let's do vertical, so when the Y position is at 0%, basically at the top, we can add font variation and just add the axis. Let's make the weight here super thin when the mouse is at the top. And I'll add one more at the bottom. At 100%, I want to add a font variation. And I'll go in and add the axis for weight. But this time, I'll make the weight super heavy. If I switch on live preview, I can hover over the viewport and I'm continuously animating the heading on mouse move. Top 0%, bottom 100%. But that's it. We can add a variable font by uploading a variable font, and we can choose it from the little dropdown thing. We can control all sorts of axes by adding axes and controlling them. We can control different states like hover and even add transitions to animate those state changes. And finally, we can add interactions that control all kinds of axes, like mouse move controlling the weight of the font, or the slant of a font, or the position of the tiny star that lives atop the screen.